Hiroshi Harada's Midori is an independently produced gyro horror adult animated film. Inspired by Suehiro Maruo's cult gyro manga, the film adaptation is written, illustrated, and animated solely by Hiroshi Harada himself, also directed by Harada, but under the pseudonym of Hisaki Etsu. The film's animation and aesthetic consists of still illustrations, paintings, and traditional animation. Despite its modest, low-budget creation, Midori is a film which aspires to be devastating, its reputation suggesting it to be one of the most disturbing, violent animated films to exist. The film focuses on a young girl named Midori who discovers the death of her mother, presented as a half-rotten corpse. As a recent orphan, she is manipulated, gaslit, and forced into working for a travelling troupe of sideshow performers for the circus, where she is beaten, raped, and intimidated by everyone she is made to work with. Midori is a film of quite a speedy pace necessary to fit everything inside to the space of a running time under 50 minutes long. Due to this, the film is filled with scenes where misery, dread, abuse, and extreme violence is depicted. Very few scenes remain untouched, from orgies, crushed puppies, rotting corpses, nightmarish transformations, and psychological degradation. Midori is a target of abuse. She is offered a glimmer of hope through the introduction of a mysterious, enigmatic magician who joins the travelling troupe of performers. A small man who performs an act of entering a bottle through its thin neck. This magician and Midori fall in love. He shows her kindness and tenderness, two things which Midori has clearly gone too long without. However, this magician is not a particularly good influence either, as his thin temper with a belligerent audience shows. The magician, with all his fury, transforms his audience into contorting, mutating, ambiguously morphing demonic-like impossibilities. This sequence in particular is, while immense, disturbing, is also spectacular, a true sight for any fan of animation. The ambitions of Hiroshi Harada's ability as an animator truly shine here, as the audience is individually, one by one, melting into horrendous forms, which reflect the ugliest aspects of organic matter. Nightmarish, such visuals are a marvel to behold, reflective of the similar spectacle of a fascinating magic trick, or an unusual talent one might see at such a sideshow performance, as if presented in a way like the horrors of a Junji Ito manga. While Midori is extremely violent, its most extreme misery comes in the form of psychological degradation. Midori is a character that, at any opportunity, is abused. When she falls in love with the magician who marries her, she becomes momentarily more confident in herself due to the hope he gives her. But during Midori's momentary confidence boost, she is faced with twice as much harassment and hatred. No abuse at all is deserved, and Midori is a victim of this vicious cycle where the moment she begins to feel a slight sliver of positivity, she is made to be belittled and demeaned by a circus performing cohorts. While the initial shock of these scenes is difficult to watch, the psychological implication is much longer lasting. Midori, faced with such abuse so frequently, is going to face long lasting consequences of this. Her mental health will take a devastating toll, as the climactic sequence of the film implies. Saying her final farewells to the rest of the circus performers, Midori and the magician set off on their own independent path, but as Midori loses track of her magician husband, she is sent into a spiral of madness. Hurriedly running to find her husband, she is faced with dead ends and frequent repetitions that seem to test her psychological well-being even further. When such a dependency on the person who offered Midori the most support, friendship, and solidarity cannot be fulfilled, it fills Midori with dread. What would happen to Midori without her magician? How can she cope without his protection when, as her previous experiences suggest, everyone else in the world is so violently intentioned? The rush of fear overtakes her, causing her to psychologically spiral downwards. When considering the misery on offer in Hiroshi Harada's film, the most unsettling moment may just be when Midori is left psychologically broken. In conclusion, Hiroshi Harada's Midori is an extreme animated film focusing on the degradation of Midori, a low-budget, highly independent anime film. Filled to the brim with shocks and horrors, Midori is also a film which offers some highly impressive animated sequences. It is a cruel, mean-spirited viewing experience that is not intended for light viewing, and yet, despite all the extremities of its violent spectacles, the most significant, unsettling devastation that Midori offers is the psychological breaking of a young human being. It is a film which explores the horrors and the extent to which a human being can be destroyed. Thank you.